Hi everybody, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited. I've got 4 samples of niche perfumes which I've ordered, and this is, I mean, I smelled a few niche perfumes in store, but now I can really make a better review. And this is basically my first time with niche perfumes, so be gentle, I'm a virgin. I got 4 samples and I try to pick things that I love and that I don't really have any perfumes with these notes in my collection, to see if there's something so special in niche perfumes and their longevity, projection. So I don't know if you can see, but yes, I marked where I sprayed, so I will know. I've also sprayed on the strip. So without further ado, I will read you the notes. I will also add them somewhere on the screen so you can see. I've had some notes, things that I felt when I smelled them. So without further ado, I'm so excited. By the way, pause the video, grab something to drink or to eat or both. I feel a little chatty today, so I'm sorry. It is what it is. It's going to be a long one, I guess. So the first one that I got, I was really curious by the company's name and the idea behind it. They called Musicology. They also have in Braille here. Probably can't see it. And their perfumes, each one of them is named after a song. So this one is Close to Midnight. I'm embarrassed to say I don't know who wrote it, but to the perfume itself. So top notes are coffee and jasmine, middle notes are labdanum and tonka beans, and base notes are ambergris and musk. I have to say that right now I like this perfume, but the opening was not for me. The opening was very ambery, vintagey, something between sweat and cat pee. I know it sounds really bad, but some of the vintage perfume smells to my nose really outdated, and there's something in them that I don't like. I prefer modern perfumes. I know. Maybe my taste will change when I'll be more into the perfume world and I can appreciate other things, but as for now, I prefer the modern perfumes. So right now, I really smell the tonka bean. But you can still smell in the background the vintage amber, and in the initial spray it really reminded me of perfume. You know that you remember a song but you can't find exactly which song is it? You remember a line or a part of the melody. So I have it with this one. My cat just went to take a dump, so I'm sorry for the noise. Also, it's noon here, so if you're hearing my neighbors and traffic outside, then I'm sorry about that. To be honest, I was really, really excited for this one. I really love the concept of what are they doing, and the bottles look really cute. They have like a record on them, like with a necklace, the same. It really reminds me the bottles of Van Cleef and Arpels. I'm sorry. So I'm a bit disappointed. I would say I don't like the beginning. The dry down about 40 minutes later is really nice, but to wait that long, and by the way, they're very pricey. I wrote that it reminds me like a nightclub or a dark bar. Smokiness. It's very mature, very, very vintagey. And I would give it 5 out of 10. It's my opinion. If you like it, who am I to say what's a good perfume? The next one is from Juliette as a Gun, Lady Vengeance. I was considering there was a holiday, an Israeli love holiday, you know. So I saw a kit of samples from Juliette as a Gun, and I was thinking that maybe I'm gonna buy it, but I've looked on the perfumes that they have samples in it. And to be honest, I maybe want to try one or two, but I don't see a point in buying things I don't want only for the sake of trying. I'm trying to be more mindful, and even now when I got things that I thought I'm going to like, you know, you imagine perfumes, you read the notes, and you think they're going to be a certain way, and they turn out completely different. You can have two perfumes with the same notes and they will smell absolutely different. I don't know what makes it that way. Maybe you use better materials in one, or maybe the scents are actually accords of a few scents together, and when they say amber, then one house is interpreting amber as an accord with these notes, and other house is using a different notes for amber. But anyway, I told you, I'm going to be chatty. So, Lady Vengeance. Top notes, lavender and bergamot. Middle notes, Bulgarian rose, Moroccan rose, patchouli, Isoe Super and geranium, and base notes are white musk, ambroxan, and vanilla. I really, really like this perfume. I mean, I thought I'm going to like it. It has this goth vibe to it, and I dig that vibe, and I like rose. And the initial scent when I sprayed it is that it's blended very well. I mean, I don't like lavender note in perfumes, and I smell a shadow of lavender, but not I would, if I didn't read that there's a lavender note, then I probably wouldn't know that there is. And the roses smell like really nice, pretty much realistic, I would say. And it's like you just put the roses in water and you're smelling the stems. I know it sounds a bit weird, but to me it smells like that, like roses that you spilled water on them or something like that, something watery. And then it smells a bit soapy, not too clean, but it smells like really high-end soap that you took a shower and this is your skin, or I don't know. It smells so good. It's really nice. I mean, it's very feminine. Like a pretty goth girl that you look at her and you wish you were a lesbian. That's a very nice perfume. And I would give it 7 or even 8 out of 10 because I'm not sure how longevity is. I tried it and it's been around almost 2 hours, but you know, it's not enough to test perfume like that, to spray it on a strip and on your hand, and it takes time. On my skin, it's less dominant than on the paper strip, which is my problem with perfumes. It smells, the bottle is black, which in the name Lady Vengeance, you know, you expect it to be something dark, and I smell this darkness in the background. I mean, it's a pretty scent, but soul is dark. I really like it. It also reminds me a bit of Narciso Rodriguez for her, the EDP one. It's more oily, it's not dry or something, but I love it. There's from the four samples that I got, this one is the cheapest. The other ones are like $200 a bottle. It's very expensive. This one is the most affordable one, and this one also is my favorite one. I'm sorry if I ruined the suspension. So there's a good chance that I will buy a full bottle of it. So, the next perfume sample that I got is by a brand that's called Ciro. I will try to read the name of the perfume, but let me say I'm sorry in advance because I don't know any French. It was a bit the offside. So feel free to laugh. Le Chypre du Nil, if I understand it correctly. It's the Chypre of the Nile, the river, the Nile. And let me show you the presentation. Isn't that the most pretty sample that you ever seen in your life? By the way, I couldn't find almost any reviews on this perfume or brand called Ciro, like I said. They're very expensive. Check the prices. And I'll read you what I thought of the scent. The initial spray is very fresh, dry. It's unisex. I mean, I like those type of scents. It reminds me of vintage citrus with vintage wood combined. I will read you the notes, I forgot. Top notes are Calabrian bergamot, LME, wormwood, Sichuan pepper. Middle notes are damask rose, dried fruit, orris root, and base notes are patchouli, amber, and suede. So you can probably guess that it's smells pretty unisex, and the weirdest thing that it reminded me, I don't think it have any notes that you have in lay of Emporio Armani, my signature scent, but it smells like its cousin. I mean, they're not, I wouldn't say that they smell alike, but I feel that they smell in the same vibe. So I kind of like it. I mean, it's more masculine than lay. And if you will read in Fragrantica, a lot of people say that lay is a unisex scent. I encouraged my ex-boyfriend to buy the men's version of lay. I'm not sure how it's called. And they're pretty similar. The men's version is more masculine. And I used it a lot of times, by the way. But this is more masculine than that. I totally love it. It's really something citrusy and fresh with wood. It's not really sweet. It has this dry sweetness, a subtle sweetness. A hint of sweetness. I would give this perfume 7 out of 10. Lady Vengeance is 8 out of 10, and this is 7 out of 10. I really like it. And last, I got Nishane Fan Your Flames. I don't know why I'm showing you the strip, but yes. So, first of all, I've smelled Annie and 100 Silent Ways in a store. And I really liked 100 Silent Ways. Also, I smelled the Wulong Cha. It's a tea scent. And all of them. By the way, I'm curious. Wulong Cha in Mandarin means 5 dragon tea. Am I right about it? Anyway, all of them are very strong. I mean, most of the time I work at home or with elderly people or in an office. I work in a few places. None of them is good enough reason to wear that strong of a perfume. I barely go out. I mean, where will I go? With who? All my friends have children and none of them like going out. Anyway, where will I wear it? I mean, even if I would want to splurge, their perfumes are really expensive, of Nishane. They're very strong, so you get a bang for your buck, at least that, and they're very long-lasting. And if you want to be noticed, then they're really the house for you. So, I will read you the notes. Top notes are coconut and rum. By the way, side note, rum is my favorite drink for ever. I really prefer the dark, smoky rum. And by reading the notes, I thought it's going to be a perfume that I'm really going to love. Middle notes are tobacco and tonka bean. Base notes are Chinese cedar and oak moss. And I don't have any tobacco perfume, so as an ex-smoker, I was really curious. I really wanted to see how the perfume world interpret tobacco. So after a while, it does become less strong, but this perfume is so strong, even to my taste. If I say that the perfume is strong, let me tell you, it is hella strong. I mean, usually I don't mind perfumes that are like taking up a room, but their perfumes are really even loud for me. So what I wrote, what I think about this perfume, it's masculine. If you're a feminine woman, I don't think you're going to love it. It's vintagey. It reminds me, when I was a child, I think they still have these, but maybe where you live, you had it in a different name. In Israel, it's called Carvol, and there are ampoules. So when you have a cold and your nose is stuffed, you drop it on your pillow and it's like piney, and I'm not sure, it has a really specific scent and it opens your airways so you can breathe when you sleep. Usually you give it to kids. I mean, you don't use it on your body, but you use it on your pillow. So the beginning is like identical to it. It smells very medicinal, green forest, like you chopped some pines, and you have this resinous smell of green piney, pine soap, which we also have it here in Israel. My mother loves it. It's like greenish. And to be honest, I like it also, but it's quite expensive for a small bottle, so I never buy it. You can smell a bit the coconut in the background, but it's really in the back seat. You smell also the rum, but it's the harsh part of the rum. I'm not sure how to explain it. I love rum because it's made out of sugar. I don't like alcoholic drinks that are made from grains. Like I rarely drink beer or vodka or things like that because my body somehow doesn't... I always get hangovers, so I usually drink arak, which is like ouzo from anise, or rum is my favorite drink, which is from sugarcane, and it somehow works good with my body. I don't know. I know it sounds weird, but you know, I've tried, trust me. So when it dries down, it's really nice, but it takes a lot of time until it dries down, and still it's very masculine. But if you're into unisex scents, then you might like it. Let's say I won the lottery or had a sugar daddy or something, which money wasn't a problem. Then, oh, by the way, I give it a 6 out of 10. I imagine it a bit different, and it's really... I mean, for a guy, I would love the scent of Nishane, but the Fan Your Flames. But I expect it to be less harsh, and it's quite harsh. So, if I was a rich girl, I would definitely get the Lady Vengeance. I would probably get the Ciro one because I like this type of scent. I mean, there's a reason why Lay is my signature scent for over 20 years, and I can't get enough of it. I'm not sick of it. I always want to use it. I have a bunch of perfumes and I still use it a lot. And they have a similar vibe. The only difference I would say that Lay is smelling more oily or rich, and this is more dry. And Fan Your Flames, I don't know if I would buy it even if I was super rich. I mean, I like the idea of the scent, but I'm not sure that I want to smell like that, you know? Maybe once or twice a year, yes, but for that I'm okay with getting another one or two samples and I'm done for life. I mean, so that's it. If you watched up to here, then thank you very much. I was so excited to get those samples, and as you can clearly see, I was really excited to film this video. So let me know if you try these perfumes, or what do you think about niche perfumes in general? Do you like them? And I will see you in the next video. Have a great day. Bye.